Welcome to Unit 1, the Organization of the Human Body. This module is essential in providing us background information so that we can be prepared for the rest of the semester. All right, so let's get started. Of course, we need the obligatory definition of anatomy. Anatomy is the study of the structure of the human body, but also the relationship between and among the structures. So not only will we study the human body, but we study the human body relative to other structures. We don't just jump from heart to brain to blood to bones. We're going to organize this semester into organ systems. And so then we talk about all of the structures of an organ system, but we also have to talk about the organ systems relative to one another. So it's really important to understand that it's not only the study of the structures, but also the relationship between them. We also need to define physiology. I'm guessing most of you will take physiology after you take anatomy, so it's good to know the definition now. And really, we can't talk about anatomy without also addressing some physiology. Yes, we try to focus exclusively on the anatomy, but physiology leaks in a little bit. So physiology is the study of the function of the human body, the structures, the organs, the tissues. So not only do we talk about the heart, of course, we have to talk about heart anatomy, for example. We need to talk about the chambers and the valves and the blood vessels going to and from the heart. But then we're going to also touch upon the electrical conduction of the heart and some of the mechanical processes of the heart as well. But then next semester, when you take physio, you will really immerse yourselves in the physiology of all of the structures that you've learned this semester. Gross anatomy is the study of all of the structures that we can see with the naked eye. Much of what we do this semester is gross anatomy. So, for example, when we go into the lab and we look at the bones, for example, we're going to be studying gross anatomy. We can hold the bones in our hands. We can touch the structures. We can feel for the processes and the facets. And all of that we can see with the naked eye. A lot of what we do is also microanatomy, and we'll talk about that on the next slide. Microanatomy is the study of structures using a microscope. So when I said that we'll be studying bones, yes, we will. We'll be studying the gross anatomy of the skeletal system, but when we study the microanatomy of the skeletal system, we're going to be looking at bone tissue under the microscope. And so this picture here is what bone looks like under the microscope. It sort of arranges in these cylindrical structures. You're going to learn the names of those. And it is very interesting to study tissue under the microscope. In fact, we have a whole chapter where we talk about tissue. Another very important term is histology. Histology is the study of tissue. Tissue is a very important chapter. It's one of the first chapters we cover. We're actually going to cover the skeletal system first, but then we will cover tissue because really the rest of the semester, we need to be comfortable talking about tissue so that when we get to the digestive system and we talk about the lining of the stomach, we're very comfortable referring to simple columnar epithelial tissue. I know that's a term you haven't heard before, but you'll get to know it pretty quickly. Or when we talk about the nervous system, we're very comfortable talking about neurons and glial cells. All of that needs to be addressed sooner than later. And so I need you to understand tissue pretty quickly. Dissection is what we do when we are in the lab. So dissection is a great tool for learning and studying the human body. Often we dissect cats. You've probably dissected a fetal pig, maybe a frog. But it's really important to learn to dissect so that you can see underlying structures, internal structures, and understand the relationship between them, among them. One final term that's very important to know right off the bat is the term homeostasis. Homeostasis is going to become essential next semester when you take physiology. But it's probably a good idea to understand what it means now. Homeostasis is the body's sort of attempt to maintain this constant internal environment despite the ever-changing external environment. Body temperature is a great example of homeostasis. Even when it's hot outside, like it gets in the valley, maybe 112 degrees outside, regardless of that external temperature, your body maintains its internal temperature at about roughly 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit. And to do that, some mechanisms are utilized. And one of those mechanisms would be sweating. So there's a system of feedbacks that then results in the body sweating, which cools the body and maintains that internal environment. Conversely, if it's really cold outside, which it doesn't get too bad here in California, but if it's cold, say 32 degrees or 20 degrees, that's very cold outside. But even if it's cold outside, your body doesn't go down to that temperature. It remains at about that 98.6 degrees. And the mechanisms that come into play there would be the opposite of sweating, which would be shivering, as well as vasoconstriction of your blood vessels so that you don't lose heat to the environment. And so there are all kinds of examples of homeostasis. Heartbeat, blood pressure, calcium concentration, glucose concentration. And we will touch upon all of these throughout the semester. But it's a pretty good idea to get an idea of what it means now so that you can be ready for physiology. So that concludes our first little lesson on the organization of the human body.